Hello learners, myself Dr. Kiran Lata Dangwal from Department of Education, University of Lucknow. Today I am going to discuss about the module 31, that is about rubric, its concept and educational uses. Evaluation is the process of examining a subject and rating based on its important features and performance factor. There are two types of evaluation, summative evaluation and formative evaluation, which are considered different from each other because they are used in different ways and for different purposes. In formative evaluation, learning to learn. Generally, we do learning to learn. And in summative evaluation, learning assessment is done. Good quality evaluation of any performance depends on correct and reliable tool of measurement and evaluation. General understanding is appropriately examined with the help of simple quantitative tools like multiple choice tests, true-false quizzes, and vocabulary definitions. On the other hand, higher order thinking, procedural knowledge, and attitude formation require more sophisticated evaluation system. Rubrics are one of the useful evaluation tools. The main purpose of rubric is to assess performances and is very helpful tools that can be measured higher level conceptual knowledge, performance skills and attitudes. A rubric is an evaluation tool or set of guidelines used to promote the consistent application of learning expectations and learning objectives and finally the learning standards in the classroom. A rubric is a scoring tool used to evaluate, assess a set of list of criteria used for assessing a particular type of work or performance and provide more details rather than a single grade or mark. The criterion help students to have a concrete understanding and visualization of what is done. Each standard or criteria also includes a gradation scale of quality. Rubric rating scale could be numerical, qualitative, or combination of both. Rubrics have become popular with teachers as a mean of communicating for an assignment, feedback on work in the progress, and grading. It is an assessment tool that clearly indicates achievement criteria across all the components of any kind of student work, from written to oral to visual. The word rubric derives from Latin word that is rubrica. Its meaning is red ochre or red chalk or coloring matter. And it originates in medieval illuminated manuscripts from the 13th century or earlier. A rubric divides the assigned work into component part and provides clear descriptions of the characteristics of the work associated with each component at varying levels of mastery. Rubrics can be used for a wide array of assignments like papers, projects, oral presentations, performances, and group projects. Rubrics are typically displayed in the form of grid. The left-hand column of the grid lists the objectives that are being evaluated. You can view in slide also that in horizontal axis, criteria are written, and in vertical axis, grading scales are given. The cells in the each row describe in a few phrases specific criteria for receiving a low, medium, or high score. Rubrics can be used in any subject area like maths, biology, physical education, economics, geography, and many other subjects. Rubrics can also be adapted and used with various ages also. And basic information which a rubric includes that is the educational purpose of an assignment and the rationale behind it, and the specific criteria or learning objectives, the specific quality standard. Rubrics are designed to be simple, explicit, and easily understood, which help students to see connections between learning, means what will be taught, and assessment, means what will be evaluated. There are two major aspects of rubric. First is coherent set of criteria, and the other aspect is descriptions of levels of performance for these criteria. Rubrics are good or bad. It depends on criteria selected and the descriptions of the level of performance under each. Effective rubrics have appropriate criteria and well-written descriptions of the performance. Now we will discuss about the purpose of rubric. Purpose of rubric is basically it is assessing students' performance, then identifying standards and level of completeness. Another purpose of rubric is by determining the level of perfection on the basis of rubric criteria and by making appropriate scoring, closely examine the student's work. Next is improve learning and improvement in students' end result. It is also helpful in diagnostic assessment. It describes qualitative as well as quantitative differences. This is also a method of rating student work in a more objective manner. Now we will discuss about the characteristics of rubric. A well-developed rubric is both. It is an instructional tool and assessment mechanism. A rubric is a scoring tool for estimating performance in any field, including co-curricular activities and social personal traits. Rubric allow standard assessment, make grading simpler and more transparent. One of the characteristics is quality rubric are way for students to reflect on and then improve their performance. An effective rubric must possess a specific list of criteria, so students know exactly what the teacher is expecting. Every good rubric contains 4 or 5 main points and subcategories of main points too. A rubric is a great way to determine a grade. This lets the students to know about their performance or explains in more detail what needs to be improved. Rubric enables to draw the overall conclusion about students' achievement. Now, we will discuss about the parts of rubric. There are 4 basic components of an assessment rubric. These are the various components like standard, criteria, descriptors, summative, outcome. Now, first of all, we will discuss about the criteria. This can be viewed on the slide that this part is the criteria. The rows of the rubric are referred as criteria, but may also be referred as dimensions. Criteria are the properties or characteristics on which assessment task is going to be judged. Each criterion describes an element that is critical to success on the assignment and elements that characteristics good performance of task, the skill, knowledge, and other aspects. Second criteria is, or we can say second component is levels of mastery. It can be viewed on slide that this part is the levels of scale. The columns of the rubric are called levels. The levels of the rubric describe varying descriptions of student success. There are a number of ways to set up the levels in rubric. We can write these levels in both ways, qualitative as well as quantitative. For example, we can write exemplary, acceptable, unacceptable, or we can say proficient, marginal, advanced, and further we can give any kind of levels. And in numerical form, or in we can say in quantitative form, we can say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or further. Now we will talk about the descriptor, which is the next component of rubric. It can be viewed on slide, that this is the part which is shown on slide, that is descriptors. Descriptors are the field or boxes or cells in the rubric where levels and criteria intersect. These boxes are also called level descriptors or success descriptors. A descriptor is a description of student success on criteria at a specific level. Descriptors specify the meaning of each criterion, describe level of performance. And the last component of the rubric is summative outcome. In slide, we can view that at the bottom of the rubric, summative outcome is given. Summative outcome are written at the bottom of the rubric, and this is the overall judgment of the assessment work of the student. This assessment work that counts towards the student's final grade in the subject or assignment. Now we will discuss about the types of rubrics. Generally, there are two types of rubric. First is holistic rubric and second is analytic rubric. Now, first of all, we will discuss about the analytic rubric. This is the standard grid rubric that many teachers routinely use to assess students' work. Analytic rubric divides a product into essential components or dimensions, or we can say traits, and each dimension is judged separately and students get feedback on each component. It is a two-dimensional rubric with level of achievement as columns and assessment criteria as rows. This is the optimal rubric for providing clear and detailed feedback. The overall achievement can be determined by pointing different points of different criteria and by summing all the norms. Each component is scored individually and those scores are added for a total. With an analytic rubric, criteria for the student's work are listed in the left column and performance level are listed at across the top. The squares inside the grid contain the specs for each level. The top axis includes values that can be expressed either numerically or by letter grade or scale from exceptional to poor. The side axis includes the assessment criteria for each component. An analytic rubric can also permit different weightings, or we can say weightages, for different components. Assign different weights to different criteria can be overall achievement by totaling the criteria written in a table form. And it can be viewed in slide also, that analytic, how we can describe or how we can show analytic rubric. Now we will talk about holistic rubric. Holistic rubric provides a broad overview of student performance and allow assessing a learning task as a whole. It is a single criteria rubric, or we can say one-dimensional rubric, used to assess participants' overall achievement on an activity or item based on predefined achievement levels. The holistic rubric is laid out in a slightly different way, with the rating scale along the left side with the criteria and descriptors combined under description. This is a type of rubric that is much easier to create but much more difficult to use accurately. It is based on predetermined achievement levels and it is used to assess the overall achievement of the participant on any activity or item. It can be viewed on slide also. This is holistic rubric. Now, we will discuss about the development of a rubric. Rubrics are a great way to improve communication, learning, and grading fairness, and tool to help evaluate students' performance. Therefore, it is important for a teacher to know how to create and use rubric, gives a better understanding of assessment and another option of assessing students' performance. So, before creating a rubric, one need to take care of many things. Now, these are the steps. There are basically 6 steps to create a rubric. First step is about the reflection, means defining the purpose and goal of assignment, that why we are going to create a rubric. The first step in creating any rubric is to clarify the purpose of the assignment and identify the task. Students need to learn, and it is very important that the purpose should be well defined in advance. Now, the second step, that is choose rubric type. Basically, there are 2 types of rubrics, as we discussed earlier also, means there are 2 types of rubrics, analytic rubric and holistic rubric. The type of rubric you use depends on the purpose, the assessment, that what type of rubric you choose. It is better to choose holistic rubric if you want to make a general judgment, assess a minor assignment, or provide summative feedback about overall student performance on a learning task. Analytic rubric can be used if you want to assess a multidimensional assignment or provide formative feedback about students' performance on an individual element of learning task. Now, step 3, that is about determine and define criteria. This is the step in which criteria are determined and defined. The criteria mentioned in rubric are individual elements of a learning task that have to be judged. It can be viewed that on the left side there are criteria. On way to help define criteria is to perform a task analysis of the knowledge and skill required for the learning task. Now, the step 4, that is about the creation of performance levels or rating scales. In step 4, designing the rating scale has to be determined and the number of rating scale points has to be decided. Deciding the number of rating scale depends on the purpose of rubric and assignment. After determining the broad level it is needed to figure out what type of scores will be assigned based on each task. Most rating scales include between 3 to 5 levels. Some teachers make use of a combination of numbers and descriptive levels. This can be arranged from highest to lowest or lowest to highest to make it easy to understand. Now, the step 5, performance descriptors for each scale point. Fifth step in creating rubric is to write descriptions, means performance descriptors for each scale point. And writing performance description is a tricky step, but if characteristics of good descriptors are clear, then writing good descriptors is very easy. Descriptors need to use parallel and consistent wording in each point across the scale. It is not admirable writing new description for each rating scale. The description of the behavior should be the same across the scale, but it will vary in degree. Now, the last step, step 6, that is about the revision of rubric. This is the last and final step of creating rubric. In this, we need to revise language, scale, and descriptors. Now, we will discuss about educational uses of rubric. Rubrics are not only assessment tools, but also a very good teaching and learning tools, which convey the teacher's expectations and they provide students a clear picture of what they need to do for the scientific or specific work. In instructional setting, rubrics clearly define academic expectations for students and help to ensure consistency in the evaluation of academic work from students to student and assignment to assignment. First of all, we can say that this is a very good assisting teaching tool. Well-defined criteria help teachers to be more focused, and learning objectives help them plan a more learning-oriented teaching. Good rubric help teachers avoid confusing the task or activity with the learning. It helps teachers to design teaching learning strategies that help bringing described behavioral changes in students. Second educational implication is better coordination between instruction and assessment. Use of rubric improves in linking the instruction with the assessment in a more refined way. Students are given a rubric at the beginning of the unit of instruction so that they can better understand the task and the key points to be focused. Receiving feedback at every step helps them to assess themselves. It also helps to determine the type of evaluation and making evaluation more organized. It is a very helpful as learning tool also. Rubric guide the students to organize their learning and are highly motivating. Rubrics are active and engaging while learning. Use of rubric reflect, analyze, and improve work. Rubric help in concept formations of students in a better way. It helps them to decide their methods for the mastery of the content. Rubric guide the students to organize their learning and are highly motivating. Rubrics are active and engaging while learning. Use of rubric reflect, analyze, and improve their work. These are also helpful in learning. And the key point to be focused and receiving feedback at every step help them to assess themselves, and it also helps to determine the type of evaluation and making evaluation more organized. It is very helpful in learning also. Rubric guide the students to organize their learning and are highly motivating. Rubrics are active and engaging while learning. Use of rubric reflect, analyze, and improve work. Rubric helps in concept formations of students in a better way. It helps them to decide their methods for the mastery of the content. It is a very good in supporting also for a teacher. To evaluate the students' work, always a challenging task for the teachers. Rubric is used to maintain objectivity and accuracy in evaluation. Teachers use rubric to support learning and assessing the students' work efficiently, consistently, objectively, and quickly. Rubrics enable teachers to evaluate students' performance in situations that are more closely replicate real life than an isolated test. Rubrics allow teachers to accommodate and differentiate for heterogeneous classes by offering a range of quality levels. And it is a very good tool for grading also, and it encourages students also. Rubrics are used to grade student work. Grading is descriptive set of criteria that is designed to reflect the weighted importance of the objectives of the assignment. Through rubric, we get a consistency of grade. It ensures the teacher's grading standards don't change over time and minimize the error due to fatigue, shifting standards of any other factors. Rubrics can help instructors get a clear picture of the strengths and weaknesses of their classes. It is also very good for monitoring also of own work. A rubric places the students in a position of a self-evaluator. They can easily monitor their own progress, and this makes students more motivated to improve. When rubrics are given to students with the assignment description, they can help students monitor and assess their progress as they work towards clearly indicated goals. When assignments are scored and returned with the rubric, students can more easily assess the limitations of their work and make efforts in a right direction. We can say that it is a very good assessment tool also. And the main purpose of rubric is its ability to assess students' performance or work. Rubrics can be tailored to each assignment. When rubrics define clear learning objectives, teachers can quickly and effectively monitor students, and it also allows for monitoring of students that are not able to reach the average mark, and thus teacher can plan some remedial measures for them. It is also a very good communication tool. Rubrics can be seen as a communication tool between student and teachers, as it aligns expectations and outlines learning objectives for the assignment between student and teachers. One main benefit of aligning and clearly stating expectations is that it creates transparency in grading. And we can do quality assessment through rubrics. With traditional assessment-based practices, it is not always easy for teachers to monitor and learn and grow their students. A rubric gives the students relevant and timely feedback without diminishing their effort into preparing the assignments. With rubrics, teachers can align their standards of proficiency based on the skill sets they have already taught. Next educational uses of rubric is metacognition. With the use of rubrics, teachers give students experience in their higher level thinking processes. Rubrics encourage students to think about their own thinking and possibly about their own criteria for what is better. Teachers provide parents with a digestible, concise, and well-structured assessment. Parents appreciate the use of rubrics because they allow teachers to justify why a certain grade was assigned to his or her child. Rubrics are easy to understand at a quick glance. So, dear learners, let us summarize. In a nutshell, we can say that rubrics are, or we can say they provide students with a clear expectations about how to obtain a particular score. They are quick, objective, and efficient. The gradation on a rubric allows students to identify their strengths and weaknesses. Students become more objective and thoughtful judges of their own quality of work and the quality of their classmates' work. In this module 31, we have discussed about rubric and its types, development, and its educational implications. Hope all points are clear to you and you will apply this knowledge to enhance your ability. Wishing you all the best and fruitful learning through Swayam for completing this refresher course. Thank you and best wishes.